Yeah, Tormod. Let's do one more. Sparkling water. That makes me sad. Hey, Dispatch Rabbi, how's it going? Is not as good as I would like it to be, but it's something. Dispatch Rabbi, runs are pretty good. First run of the night was a 1 hour and 4 second run. Then we just got a 59 minute run, so sub 100% is definitely real. Thank you. Look, I didn't say that I'm happy with the runs. I said runs are going well. The runs going well exists on a relative scale. That's an important point to remember. Alright, so I need to remember the stutter step here. Might be a place to grind. Nah, not worth my time. That was an experiment. That particular Archer has a 1 in, I think it's 1 in 16, chance to drop 62 gold. But it's not worth it. I'm pretty sure like half of its drops are magic. So if you don't get that 1 in 16, it's not good times. Now that said, we do have a new route. Just finished tweaking it. Please die in one hit. Thank you. Welcome back, Hockey. You missed in that ridiculous run that you left in the middle of. A sub 1 hour, somehow. That's fine. Hopefully that at least gives us some help in the RNG. Yes, it does. Awesome. Okay, I still need to collect coins. Good enough. That's not enough money. That's fine. We'll make do. This will be fine. But I'm not super thrilled about the amount of money that I got out of that. Yeah, I did the thing. I remain amazed that I managed to do the thing, but I did the thing. Dispatch Rabbi, I just had to reset a bunch of golds, so that gold is pretty fake. But we've been experimenting with different route decisions that have changed a bunch of the best segments by moving both the early and the late gold grinding around. So a lot of the golds in this run is going to have some golds for sure. a lot of the golds were going to be fake. Alright. Compared to last run, gold-wise, we're not that badly off. Last run, I had 1170. Of course you give me a spell, jerk. Need money. Are you there though? Almost. Nice, we're good. I'm mad about that wrong input. Alright, well, I think I have sufficient boomerangs for this run. That's fair. That was bad movement on my part. Stop it. How do you know that these skeletons don't have brains? Okay, yeah, maybe it doesn't have a head. But that's no reason to call it dumb. It's just rude. Just plain rude. Alright. We've had really bad RNG so far tonight here. Hopefully we have a better fight. off to a great start. Well, I'm just gonna take my foot off the split pedal because it's gonna be a while. Please come back. I need that thing you have. I guess technically I don't really need it, do I? Worth, maybe. Not worth it. Definitely not worth it. Not worth that gamble. Sometimes. You know what really bugs me though? Is that this is a fantastic controller except for the D-pad. Pretty bad, but not the worst it could have been. Hey, Garrett, how's it going? Fine. fine. Just go that way. Thank you. Not good, but we're out. Not good, but shockingly mediocre. It's fine. Yeah, so that is what's called the unknown section. They added one unknown to, for each of the creatures that you can be transformed into, as kind of like challenge sections. Have any of those. That's not good. That's not good at all. Yeah, at the end you pick up a charm stone, which is an item that it's an item that they pulled in as an homage to the original game. Oh nice, you were supposed to die in one hit. It's fine, this is fine. Just, you know. Maybe let's stop hecking up now. But in the original game, you had to collect charm stones to be able to even purchase anything in the shops. Basically, the idea was that you were this, you know, this monster, and the shops obviously didn't want to deal with you. But if you had enough charisma, you could convince them to let you purchase things from them. I just had a thought. Was that the second room or the first room that I was in there? Basically, for anybody who was paying attention, how close was I to being able to just walk out and buy the shield? Hockey, don't pull logic into this. That's not acceptable. Thank you. Right, but it was it the second room after the key? Actually, even if it was, is that still because of the back and forth? It might just be faster to finish out that section so that I don't have to fly all the way. That's worth testing next time. That won't be an optimization tonight, but that's worth timing. Shield yet? I don't think I have. So I think I'll get that next, and I'll get the legendary shield. I need a key. Wait, what's the next unknown that I do? Does fish require a key? Yes, it does. Fish requires a key, and it's a huge pain to get. Yeah, Dispatch. I really, really like the Final Dungeon remix that they do there. Alright, we're on our way to buy the last piece of equipment that we need. I think. Yeah, pretty sure. K grind is actually 16K, as opposed to the 16K grind that has the money fall out from under us every so often. Alright, so 14 more thousand. Lots of 80s this time around. Thank you. Yeah, Dispatch, I definitely agree. Really everything that they did about the art direction in this game. It's just so, so good. Alright, I'm gonna cut it off at 14, which is unwise. No, it really is unwise. Much as I want to. No, I'm cutting it off at 14. We're collecting gold from collecting gold from what's his name. Daimyo. We're gonna collect gold from Daimyo, and it's gonna be fine. Yeah, this is a really good remake. I just realized that the anglerfish there have the same AI as the ghosts, except for the lack of a cycle where they just do nothing, where they like go in a circle the way that the ghosts do. but otherwise it's the exact same. Hmm. No tornadoes, eh? Well, that's gonna make this dungeon fun. Not particularly scared, but... doing that spread, I have to remember that I take that slight delay. It's fine. It's fine. Ah, you're supposed to drop a thing. Mouse unknown time. Have a key. No, I use the key. It's fine, just give me a key. Thank you. That's a nearly impossible jump from what I've been able to find out, or been able to prove. I can't do that jump, is what I'm saying. I'm bad at this game. Thank you. get hit? Oh, I didn't get hit. Nice. Oh, and I did that jump right to get the despawn too. That was really good. I apologize ahead of time. I am definitely going to mispronounce your handle. Hello, Snoya, maybe? It's a lot of vowels right next to each other. Thanks for the good luck. We are on a not too terrible pace right now, so we'll see what happens. Alright, I've got to farm gold off of this boss. Unknown time. Still have a key. That's right, we got it from the mouse. Cool. We don't have enough gold. This is bad. I don't have enough gold by a large amount. Really, dude? Still better than my PB. It's fine, it's fine. Just here we go. Please? There we go. Do we have enough? I don't think we do. This might be a waste of time, but that's fine. Do we? No, I think we still don't. Shoot. Alright. Next time that I say I'm just gonna farm gold off of a boss, like, somebody just call me. Call me rude names. Not the block that I needed to hit there. Gosh, this run is falling apart. I went back the correct number of times though, so at least there's that. Fine, just looking through. Nice. That was a good run. Thank you. Good fight. Okay, next up is Dragon Unknown. Alright, show me human. Yo, Oxbox! It's going pretty well. We're on a pretty okay pace, if I'm being honest right now. Hey, Hadby, how's it going? This section is so rude. Really sloppy. Worst. Sorry, come on. Mm-hmm. less fine. Thank you. One more. That was an okay fight. There we go. 58:15. I feel like that's a pretty okay time. No major screw-ups. We did mess up the money count, which kind of sucks, but... I still don't think that sub 55 is going to be particularly easy. Thanks for the GGs, everyone. So the reason that save and quit is allowed in the 100% category is because over the course of the run, you have to grind a little bit over 30,000 gold. And saving and quitting is necessary to refresh chests. And there's one chest in particular where you can go and get 3,500 gold every time that you visit it. Grinding that much gold off of killing enemies, I did a quick proof of concept run. I did a proof of concept run, and my run was like 3 hours and 20 minutes. It was abysmal. It wasn't fun to run. It wasn't fun to watch. And for that reason, we ended up just not making 100% category for a while. Another runner of this game, Chris Gator, pushed for, let's do 100% run. Let's allow save and quit. Basically, we decided that the rules would be essentially the same as any percent, except that we would also stipulate that you have to complete all dungeons, which is why the first time that I went through this game, you saw me go through the normal dungeon instead of skipping straight to the end boss. On top of that, of course, there's the permanent inventory items that you have to collect. So between those two stipulations, we came up with a 100% run. It ended up being pretty fun to run, and hopefully people have enjoyed watching it. And yeah, so Chris Gator's first run, I think, was an hour 20. My first run, I've had a lot more practice with the game. Chris Gator only started running it when it came out on PC. And I've been running it on Switch, so I've got like a month on him. But my first run was an hour and 10 minutes. And now we've managed to grind it down to sub 1, which I'm pretty happy about. But yeah, if you're looking for a run that doesn't allow save and quit, there's the no major skips category in this game, which doesn't allow save and quit, obviously. It doesn't allow the fish fly glitch, which, depending on how long you've been here, you might have seen me use a couple times in this run. And it doesn't allow you to skip going to the sunken pirate ship, which you can do even in a run that you're not getting bird early by using fish flight in. But the idea was that we wanted our no major skips, previously no major glitches category, to be pretty close to the all bosses category in the original Wonder Boy 3, which this is a remake of. But yeah, to Oxbox's point, save and quit has a huge impact in this game, which is why a 1cc run that's between 3 and 4 hours turns into a sub 1 hour run. actually pretty happy about this. This was a pretty okay run, I feel. Yeah, Oxbox is on the money there. I mean, the whole speedrun thing, like, we're imposing arbitrary rule sets on ourselves just to make it so that we can compare runs that we've had and collaborate. And a huge amount of the rule set decisions that tend to be made come from just what's fun to play and what's fun to watch. But really more to the point, what's fun to play. But if something's not fun to play or watch, it's not worth having a category for it. Yeah, Oxbox is 100% on the money. Is this a shitty run? Is a pretty major consideration in any speedrun category. Hodby. So this is my PB, which is also the world record. All right, final inventory check. Six stones. We are good.